Do I have a mental illness? I hear everyone talking about mental health, but what do they mean? And what is mental health literacy? Why does it matter? The language we use to describe mental health can be confusing sometimes, and when talking about a health issue, it is important to get the words right. Mental health literacy has been shown to improve help-seeking efficacy and decrease the time between onset of symptoms and access to getting help. It also decreases the stigma around mental illness. In this video, we will explain the difference between all of those words you hear, how to accurately talk about mental health, and how to know the difference between mental well-being, mental illness, and everything in between. Welcome to Mental Health Collaborative, a nonprofit organization dedicated to educating our community in mental health literacy. We believe that a foundational education about mental health promotion and understanding mental health and mental illness will lead to more resilient communities and decreased stigma. We believe that mental health literacy is a right and need of everyone. Thank you for joining us. Mental health literacy has four main components: understanding how to obtain and maintain good mental health, understanding and being able to identify mental disorders and their treatments, decreasing the stigma around mental illness, and increasing help-seeking efficacy. That means knowing where to go, when to go, and what to expect when you get there. All of us can benefit from mental health literacy. We can't have a conversation about mental health if we don't understand the terminology we are using. Mental health literacy puts us all on the same page so that we can move forward in educating ourselves and others. The mental health literacy pyramid separates mental health into four different levels, with the most people at the bottom and the fewest people at the top. At the bottom of the pyramid is no distress, problem, or disorder. This is when we are just living our day-to-day lives, feeling no distress, and just doing the things that we do. If we are in this level of the pyramid, we might say that we feel calm, joyful, content, and so on. One level up from that is mental distress. Mental distress is the normal negative feelings we all experience throughout our daily lives. Good old ordinary stress. Some of the adjectives that we use to describe a mental distress are disappointed, angry, frustrated, irritated, and so on. Mental distress is transient and does not require any formal treatment. Nobody escapes from experiencing mental distress. We probably all experience it on a daily basis. Above mental distress is a mental problem. Mental problems are more intense than day-to-day difficulties. If we are dealing with grief, heartbreak, and despair, we have a mental problem. Mental problems may not need medical or psychiatric care, but usually require some extra support, either professionally or from other resources. At the top of the pyramid is mental illness or disorder. To be in this part of the pyramid, we have to have a clinical mental illness that meets certain diagnostic criteria, like major depressive disorder, generalized anxiety disorder, or post-traumatic stress disorder, to name a few. We will all experience the three bottom levels of the pyramid, but only about 20% of the population will be in the top of the pyramid and have a diagnosable mental illness. That is about 1 in every 5 to 6 people. Using the right words to describe how we feel matters. If we feel calm, content, and joyful, we're not experiencing any mental distress, problem, or illness. If we feel nervous, agitated, or sad, we're experiencing mental distress. If we feel devastated, demoralized, or sorrowful, we're experiencing a mental problem. If we meet the criteria for a diagnosable mental illness, then we are experiencing a mental illness. So we've talked about feeling words for each level of the pyramid. Here are some situations related to each of those four levels. We might be experiencing no distress, problem, or disorder if we're relaxing, taking a yoga class, hanging out with friends, drinking a cup of coffee in the afternoon, or out grocery shopping or doing other errands. If we have a presentation or an important appointment coming up, we may experience some mental distress. Some other examples of things that we would describe as mental distress could include getting a flat tire, being sick when you're supposed to be on vacation, the anticipation before a first date, accidentally breaking something expensive, or getting stuck in traffic causing us to be late for an appointment. Sometimes we face greater challenges in life that we would classify as mental problems. Losing a loved one, getting a divorce, being diagnosed with a chronic illness are some examples of these greater life challenges. Some other examples of mental health problems could be losing a job, having your home destroyed in a natural disaster, or struggling with isolation and fear during a pandemic. Mental illnesses are different from mental health problems. People at the top of the pyramid have a clinical mental disorder, and there is a disturbance in their brain functioning. Some examples of mental illnesses include major depressive disorder, obsessive-compulsive disorder, and bipolar disorder. If we are experiencing a mental illness, we need help from a professional. That could include therapy, medications, or other evidence-based treatments. It's important to remember that experiencing mental distress or a mental problem does not mean you will eventually have a mental illness. All of us will experience mental distress and mental problems, but not all of us will develop a mental illness. Throughout our lives and even throughout our days, we can move between levels in the pyramid. Interestingly, we can even be experiencing all levels on the pyramid at the same time. For example, we can be calm and content during a dinner with friends, even though we have an upcoming interview for a job that we really want, have just been laid off from a job, and are being treated for bipolar disorder. Good mental health does not mean that we are always in the bottom of the pyramid. Experiencing negative emotions and life challenges are normal and do not mean that we have a mental illness. In fact, sometimes people with mental illnesses have the best mental health because they are more careful about taking care of themselves. We can have a mental illness and have better mental health than someone with no mental illness. For an example, someone with bipolar disorder may be well treated with medications and therapy and have great self-care routines like exercise, eating well, getting enough sleep, and having supportive relationships. Conversely, someone without a mental illness may be in poor mental health, getting no exercise, eating poorly, having few trusting relationships, etc. This is why language matters when talking about mental health. We might say we have a mental illness when we really have a mental problem. Or we might say we have mental distress when we really have a mental illness. Using the correct language helps us accurately talk about and describe mental health, decrease stigma, and get the right treatment if we need it. We wouldn't say we had pneumonia if we had a cold. If we had a cold, we would take it easy, rest more, perhaps take Tylenol. But we wouldn't rush to the doctor or a hospital, as we would if we had a fever, difficulty breathing, and symptoms of pneumonia. The same is true for mental illness. Feeling stressed or sad does not warrant professional psychiatric care, but having a mental illness does. If you or someone you know is suffering from a mental illness, please see the resources below for how to get help. We hope you found this information helpful. We at Mental Health Collaborative are committed to providing education and increasing awareness about all of the interrelated states of mental health. We hope that by doing this, stigma decreases and more people get proper treatment and support for mental illnesses, learn when to get help, where to get help, and what to expect when they get there.